sitting here with Coach McNair, Freddie McNair. Coach, man, just talking about your time here as a player at Alcorn State. Just talking about the teams that you played on and just the tradition and the foundation that you guys laid. The players off the top of your head, Coach, that got an opportunity that you were on the practice field with, can you name them all?
There's quite a few. You know, going back to, I think it was that the 8-8 class that we had with Gary Lewis, Elliot Smith, Jack Phillip, Willard Thomas, and those guys played in the secondary, you know, that they got a chance to go on to the next level to play football. You talk about Torrance Small, Cedric Tillman, the receiver that played with me when I was here. Even myself, you know, getting a chance to go as a free agent to the Dallas Cowboys. Went on and played 2 years in Canada and, in the World League. Finished up in the Arena Football League for about 10 years. But I know guys like that Dwayne White, you know, he was an athletic director here one time. So those guys got a chance to come back and kind of see what was going on here on this campus. Just to get those guys involved and stuff like that. Even had a chance to be on the same team as the great Isaac Holt when he was traded with the Cowboys. Got a chance to see him and Michael Irvin go at it, you know, stuff like that. I've been around guys that, you know, when I went to the Cowboys in 89, when Isaac Holt was there, man, it was some fun, man. And just riding the same elevator with him and not being able to see him play against Jackson State. And I know Mississippi Valley and Alcorn playing the big game at the Veterans Memorial Stadium in 84. Not knowing who he was or nothing like that, but got a chance to ride the same elevator with him, man. And he introduced himself. I said, man, you the guy. You know, just talk about him and Jerry Rice tied up, you know, and stuff like that, man. It's always good to know those guys. Those guys still come back and to game and stuff like that and build a relationship with this football program and this school, just having some background with knowledge and just to have those guys around just to talk about football to some of the younger guys and let them know what chances they could have, you know, so it kind of helps.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy because for years before I got here, years ago, I can remember watching Isaac Holt play, and then I get here and you tell me, like, Isaac Holt played here. And I'm like, what? Isaac Holt played here? And then you go to naming those names. And then being from the Tampa Bay area, Jimmy Giles was a name. I know he was before you here at Alcorn. But Jimmy Giles playing with the Buccaneers, not putting it back to the fact that, man, he played here at Alcorn State. And when you talk about the guys that you played with, that you came up with, the names just go on and on and on and on. But outside of the McNair name, outside of your brother, outside of yourself, what player stands out the most to you? And it's not slighting anybody, but what player stands out the most to you, like, man, that guy played here at Alcorn State?
You know, I even going back to, you know, we having the functions up in Tennessee and Collierville, seeing Milton Mack play for the Bucks too, you know, seeing him come back. And I got a chance to see Lawrence Spillers. And those guys too as well, the older guys before my time, just getting a chance to just talk with them and just kind of go with they doing. John Theory, you know.
First rounder, right?
Yes, first rounder. Great guy. You know, the late John Theory, I must say.
Yeah.
Give him his respect and things of that nature. So, but those kind of guys that, you know, kind of paved the way and, you know, give us opportunity. Back then, swag was heavy in the NFL. It was big time. It was between Alcorn and Grambling and Jackson State. You know, we was the top leaders in the SWAC going to the league.
Sending guys out,
then.
Yeah.
Yes, we were sending players out, man, a bunch of them. And so amazing now, man. It's just so much has changed with the leagues now and with the HBCUs. These guys have not having the opportunity to go to the NFL now. So we're trying to break that trend. I think we had maybe four last year to go to the league from the conference. Still not enough. You know, I think we got some legitimate players here in this conference that can go to the next level if given opportunity. So, you know, we get a chance to send some guys to the practice squad. Chris Blair was here Yep. With the Green Bay Packers, you know.
Was down in the XFL.
Yeah, now he's in the XFL. So, you know, get those guys like that, you know, just kind of opportunity for him. But, you know, it's a, he's the stand of things, how things happen in the culture now. So we just have to build the young men, mentor the young men to be better athletes and condition themselves well so they get an opportunity. You know, pro day is coming soon, so right around the corner.
We'll have several in that deal. Watching the Super Bowl this past year, well, just a couple of days ago, I didn't realize the original big receiver, Harold Carmichael, played in this league at a rival university. We won't say what university it was, but I didn't realize he played in the SWAC. That was news to me.
Not only just him playing in the SWAC, but you had, it was probably about like six or seven guys that played in the Super Bowl this weekend from Mississippi. Mississippi ties,
yeah.
You know. Yeah. So you talk about that, it go a long ways when you talk about that. Fletcher Cox, you know.
Yeah, I think he made more headway by what he had on. I think you picked that out for him.
No, I did not. I didn't pick that out. He would have been a lot better if I picked it out.
Shout out to Fletcher Cox.
Those guys make money. They can wear whatever they want to wear.
They get a stylist. If it was hot,
they can bring it out.
That's what they do.
That's what they get paid for. So.
That's what they do. Just hitting on what you're talking about, I remember when DeLance Turner. I think that was an eye opener for a lot of people. I think we had 30 of the 32 teams come to campus here to see DeLance and watch DeLance practice and go on and on. And you know, we've been blessed here to have guys continue to come. Was it like that when you were here? As far as the scouts coming,
man, I tell you what, when I played receiver then though. Me and Elliot Smith, one of the corners that played here, man, we used to top every day. Man, he really respected me as a receiver because he knew he was going to get some work from me. And that's one of the things that you know, you try to teach every day, to come be competitive. Everything you do, I don't care if you shoot marbles, you know, be competitive. You know, in those terms when he was here, and even DeLance Turner, you know, you talk about him, he got a chance just being on special teams.
Right.
Then he got a chance to play running back. He was the fourth running back for the Ravens before leaving, going to the Dolphins. And so you talk about guys like that that got a chance to go on, and these guys will have opportunity too. We got guys here now in the previous year that played that's going to have opportunity. You got Cherry Lewis. You got KJ. Yep. And you got CJ Bowler. Those guys will have opportunity. We're still playing in the second annual Legacy Bowl
coming up.
Coming up on the 28th, I think it is. So those guys like that, and get a chance to go down and watch those guys compete with some of the MEAC conference and the rest of the SWAC conference. So it should be good for them.
Cool. And we'll end it is it Roy C. Day for you today, or what we got going on today?
No, it ain't Roy C. Day today. I'm just going to kind of take it easy today and give mom a call and see what's going on with her. You know, it's Steve's birthday today, so
14.
You know,
wow.
one of those days for her. So,
yeah.
You know, with the birthday and then the 4th of July deal.
Yeah.
You know, she kind of been on the world, so I call and check on her. Not that I don't every day, but just this day that is heavily thinking right now. So,
yeah, I get it.
You know, and all that kind of stuff. So I get a chance to call her, and I'm gonna make it her day today.
Cool. Well, we appreciate it, Coach. We'll get it back to you, man. One time for my man, Freddie McNair.
All right. I appreciate y'all, man.